What I think it is.
Audrey, leave me the fuck alone.
You're better than that.
How do you know?
Because I'm your sister. I've known you all my life.
So what?
Donald, you do what I think you're about to do, they win. Everyone that's ever talked shit about you wins. You know why? Because you lose out on your life over a stupid decision made on emotion. Like, don't do it.
I know that. It's just hard. Every day I get bullied nonstop. Never ending. They show me no mercy. It's every day.
It doesn't matter. Deep down, you know that you're a kind, caring person. Don't let this hate corrupt who you are. Now let's put that away and let's have a good day.
Okay.
Come on, we're gonna be late for first period.
Okay, I'll skip.
So, how are you?
We're good.
That's good, I told you.
I know. It's pretty good to have someone that actually loves me.
Hey, I love you.
I know, I mean love, not love, love. That's not stupid, I'm sorry.
It's okay, I know what you mean. Alright, bye, I love you. Text me if something happens. I love you.
Okay. Love you. I just don't get him. Like, how do you...
Can you just leave it alone, Rich?
I'm just trying to understand him. He's like, he's your brother, you know?
Well, don't. That's just who he is. Leave it alone.
Whatever. Just trying to get to know the little freak.
Rich!
Whatever, bruh. Just forget it.
Jesus, you can be so cruel.
I gotta go. Bye. Why Rich? He is a horrible person. He makes me think of doing unspeakable things to him and the rest of this damn world. Shit, he always does. Picking on me, calling me names, pushing me around. It's not fair.
D, you wouldn't understand.
But he is not worth your time.
I know that, D, but...
But what?
Nothing.
No, tell me what makes him better than all the other boys out there that you can date.
D, it's not like that.
No, tell me exactly...
Donald, I'm pregnant.
What?
It was an accident. I never met...
Audrey, I promise this is all gonna get better. This ain't out of the world. I promise.
What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing?
D.
No, shut up. You're not even here right now.
D, this isn't you.
Shut up. This is all I am now.
Why are you doing this?
Because you are dead. They killed you.
It's not true.
Yes, it is. It's their fault.
It's my fault. I made the stupid decisions that caused me to die, not them.
It's their fault for influencing you. They may as well have killed you. Just leave.
Hey, Timmy. Yeah, sorry, babe. I haven't been talking to you or anyone else. But I'll tell you what's happening in a little bit when I get home. I'm a little bit busier now, all right? All right. Love you. Bye.
Do you know who I am?
Yes.
Do you know why I am here?
Yes, look, it's nobody's fault.
Then explain to me why my sister and my nephew's dead.
What?
Yeah, you just killed your own son. So whose fault is it?
Yours. This is your fault! You're the one that killed my son! You fucking killed her!
To my parents, I'm sorry. The news would probably paint me as some kind of school shooter. Some deranged lunatic to have it out for people at my school and those around me, but it's not true. I did what I did to get her revenge on people who murdered her and her son. They deserve to die. But in the end, she got her revenge, and now it's all over. I have nothing else to live for. She gave me hope and showed me I could be me and be happy at the same time. Her death is my death. And this is why I must go and live out whatever type of punishment God has planned for me. Just know, I love you.
I didn't want my death to be yours, too. I never wanted revenge. I just wanted you to live the life that I couldn't.
I'm sorry. Hello. My name is Matthew Wren. I'm the writer and director of this trilogy. What first started out with 2,880 minutes, then the Through the Eyes of God, and now the Revenge Game. My goal in writing this story was to shed a light on a frequent topic in our society today, and that being mass shootings and fatal murders. With 2,880 minutes, I wanted to show you the victim side of the story. I wanted to show you that their story matters, but also, I wanted to show that we spend too much time looking at that story and not the whole story. Okay. Then, with Through the Eyes of God, I wanted to give you more detail. I wanted to give you more information on the story. And now, with the Revenge Game, I wanted to show you the side of the story that isn't talked about. The murderer's side, the shooter's side. I wanted to show you that not every story, not every incident is the same as the one prior to that. That everything in this world is black and white. So, with that being said, I'd like to leave you with a couple words. First, live your life like there's only 2,880 minutes left. Then, go about your day like you're looking through the eyes of God. And lastly, never play the revenge game. It will only lead to self-destruction. Thank you for watching, and please stay tuned here at Wren Productions. And be ready for our next story with a purpose.